Evening, everyone. I am WJCL 22, Chief Meteorologist Jeremy Nelson with this live weather update. A busy day across southeast Georgia and the Lowcountry. We continue to track the impacts of Elsa as the tropical storm pushes across Georgia and eventually later on tonight moves into South Carolina, all along the way weakening just a little bit. But let's focus in on those impacts across our area. And obviously, number one impact that most of us are seeing right now is torrential heavy rain, at least some pockets of that. Lighter rain's beginning to push farther north. So in the Lowcountry, if you really have not seen so much rain today at this point, more is on the way. And we'll also discuss some of the rain totals we've already picked up here locally across southeast Georgia and the Lowcountry. As we get started, we have a lot of people hopping on our Facebook Live session. First off, we just want to welcome you in. Thank you for trusting WJCL 22 as your weather source here locally. If you want to hop in the comments, you can let us know where you're watching in from. Maybe the type of weather you've experienced so far. Some of you probably not much, just a little bit of rain. Others down in our southern tier counties have just sort of been inundated by heavy rain, especially in McIntosh and Glenn counties, and that is pushing to the north. So first things first, we've had a tornado watch for our area that was set to expire at 8 p.m. We were really anticipating this was going to be pushed a little bit farther north and also the time extended. So here's the current setup for the tornado watch. Just be aware of this before you head to bed tonight, because I want to make everyone weather aware. Make sure you have a way to get warnings in case we would have another tornado warning issued. We've had one around Candler and Bullitt County earlier on. That was sort of late afternoon, around 4:30. And then during our newscast at 6 p.m., a tornado warning that went into Glenn and also Wayne counties. And we are seeing a little bit of sporadic damage in parts of extreme southeast Georgia. So far, nothing like that in and around Savannah, but the worst of our weather conditions are still ahead of us. So that's the tornado watch until 5 a.m. Let's take a look now at our storm tracker radar network, the circulation right now with Elsa as it pushes into south central Georgia. And these very heavy torrential bands of rain and also the little dots that you see there, those are lightning strikes. So we are seeing some active thunderstorms. It's really wrapping around that circulation. You get these banding, and you can see clearly probably two or three different bands across the area. And where we had some issues earlier was within these with a little bit of rotation. And the National Weather Service, we have the chat up with Jacksonville, as mentioned, just off from St. Simons Island. We'll zoom this in here in a moment. Probably the potential for a water spout offshore. We just have to watch because those bands sometimes rotate their way in. So let's take a look here. We have a lot of people in the comments. Awesome Lowcountry representing down in Fleming, Georgia. Savannah on here. So if you can like and share this, we want to get the weather information out to as many people as possible. Where is the heaviest rain located? All right, here we go. This band that extends from pretty much Hinesville and Fort Stewart, and then curving back near coastal Liberty County. It's pushed its way through Brunswick, also Darien, now northeastern areas of McIntosh County. That has been some very heavy torrential rain. Most of the estimates are showing with that rainfall rates of about 2 to 4 inches per hour. So that means if that area of rain would be residing over your location, your backyard, for an hour, you would easily pick up 3 or 4 inches of rain. And so far, the measured rain total down in Brunswick is quickly swelling. It's now top 5 inches. So we are thinking widespread 1 to 3 inch rain totals. And then you could get some of those pockets where the rain just gushes out and you pick up maybe 3, 4, 5 inches of rain in very short order. And that is where the concern for some localized street flooding begins to hop in. So as we go through this evening, this area of rain is the heaviest so far. Hinesville, Midway, down into coastal McIntosh County. We can do a little bit of a very quick storm analysis here. I'm going to pop myself up full screen here for 1 second because this will only take a moment, and we'll then take a look at the radar here quickly at some of the rain numbers that we have across the area. And they're not as strong as it was down in the Brunswick area, but this will give you a good idea of some of the rain that we have across our area and what we're expecting moving forward. So there, we'll close that. Oh, there we go. Let's take a look at this now. These are rainfall rates, and they certainly fluctuate. But I mentioned earlier 2 to 4 inches per hour, so we're looking now more towards about 1 to 2 inches per hour. So this is the main band of rain that will continue to lift its way and sort of circulate around Elsa as we go through this evening. Now, as it does so, definitely the possibility that you get one or two of these thunderstorms that could be spinning, and that's where we have the concern that there could still be the threat of an isolated tornado. Look at this storm right now. There is so much lightning with this off from coastal Glen and McIntosh County. Wow, that is pretty incredible. We can take a look here at the lightning strikes and the number just within that one thunderstorm. Almost 300 lightning strikes, and that's just over about the last 10 to 15 minutes. So a very active thunderstorm off from our coastline, and there has been a little bit of rotation indicated with that. A water spout, they said, is possible off from the coastline. And again, if that would wrap closer to land, they would have to issue a tornado warning. So that's really why the threat of tornadoes is going to continue into this evening. How about outside on some of our live cameras right now? Let's take a look as we track Elsa out on Tybee Island. Any little bit of storm surge is probably moving in, but we're just past high tide. So the water level is up to about that lifeguard stand. That's nothing too unusual, not expecting really much in the way of coastal flooding. Winds will start to increase. Rainfall rates will start to increase on Tybee. You have not seen the worst of the weather conditions yet out on the island. Here is a live look from the Harbortown Lighthouse. Flags atop of the lighthouse, definitely starting to whip around. Winds have started to pick up some on Hilton Head Island, and really most of our area will start to see the winds ramp up from now into about midnight till 1 a.m. That's probably when winds will peak across our area as Elsa drags that core of some of the gustier winds across southeast Georgia and then pushes that into the low country. Typically, we see the strongest winds at the coastline, and especially with a southeast wind, that will probably be the case as we go into this evening. So looking through some of the comments here, down by Kings Bay Naval Base, there was a confirmed tornado, again, in extreme southeast Georgia. So I believe that's Camden County. That cell also produced some damage in the Jacksonville metro area, very likely tornado there, and then stronger rotation around that Kings Bay Naval Base down into Camden County. I've been down in that area before, but it looked like there was maybe a mobile home or RV park that had some trailers flipped down there. No reports of so far of any injuries with that, but obviously we'll keep you up to date on the very latest, and we're trying to grab a little bit of video from down in that area. Let's take this poll here for just a second with our tropical storm Elsa. This just updated a handful of minutes ago from the National Hurricane Center, and obviously not a lot has changed here, but what we're looking at is a sort of weakening tropical storm pushing across the state of Georgia, and that will cross probably near maybe Bullock, Screven, Candler counties up towards Hampton County as we push through the evening hours. That's later evening into tonight, eventually hopping into the Carolinas, and it should be a tropical depression near Raleigh tomorrow afternoon around 2 p.m. You can see that up there, that circle with the L in it. And that is the forecast position again tomorrow afternoon at 2 p.m. The pressure is also starting to rise, so most times you get the pressure rising and you don't have a strengthening storm, we'll start to see the winds weaken just a little bit or relax slightly. Motion has now started to curve it, north-northeast movement at 14, so that will be dragging this a little bit across our area as we go through this evening and tonight. Still watching very closely, though, that potential that we could have maybe a spin-up tornado. The tornado watch will continue until 5 a.m. So we sort of have a long haul the rest of this evening into tonight. And when you head to bed tonight, you definitely need some sort of method to get updated warnings in case there would be a tornado warning for your area. So we really suggest two methods. If you have a weather radio, that's awesome. I certainly know not a lot of people, though, not enough, have weather radio. So then you start to rely on TV. We will be here. If you want to head to bed, just leave your TV turned up, and if there's a warning, typically there's a little tone at the top, maybe that would wake you up. Better yet, you can download the free WJCL 22 News app, and you can get our updates sent directly to you. You can customize it. You don't have to get alerts for the entire area. So that is the ELSA forecast, but I know we had a lot of people on our Facebook Live, which is awesome. If you can like and share this, even better. And I'll hop up back to the top because we want to recap here that we have a tornado watch for our area that goes until 5 a.m. There it is. And this is really almost all of southeast Georgia and then into the Lowcountry. Our three counties there, Hampton County, Jasper, and Beaufort County, are included within this. So this will continue at least through the evening into the overnight hours, and then hopefully they'll start to trim away some of these counties that are included. One more look here at our storm tracker radar network. The heaviest rain is pushing its way to the north, and we really have to watch this cell. This is, let me see if I can add the lightning here for a second. The lightning is not on, but it's just absolutely incredible. This is an extremely strong storm that is hugging the coastline right now. And this one, we have to watch very closely because not only the lightning, but also that potential. Look at that. We could have some stronger winds contained within that. And let's take another moment here to do a little bit of storm analysis and see if we can find. So just bear with me 1 second here. I promise we'll get to this very quickly. There we go. Wow. There's very likely a minimum of waterspout offshore right now. That is a very broad area of rotation, but if that tightens up at all, we'll have possibly have some tornado warnings along coastal areas, which would be the movement of this is probably going to keep it pretty close to the coastline. So McIntosh County, then into Liberty County, then we'd have to watch Bryan and Chatham County. So this is a very strong storm that is lurking offshore. Lots of lightning and pretty pronounced broad rotation with that. And as ELSA continues to spin its way to the northeast, the potential is there for additional spin-up tornadoes, or this probably wouldn't even be a spin-up tornado. This would be a much more defined thunderstorm within that with some rotation. We'll back this up here. There it is. It's moving now. Let's zoom in here. Hopefully this one stays offshore. We don't want this one moving over land. But the potential is there for some of these stronger storms to kind of lurk around as we go through the evening. Probably not until after midnight, 1 a.m. will we work a lot of the stronger storms or the potential for tornadoes out of our area. That would probably start to push a little bit closer to Charleston by that time. All right, that is the very latest. We've chatted here for a long time. We had an awesome crowd on. Again, if you can like and share this, it really helps us get the weather word out to as many people as possible across the area. And again, we'll be covering ELSA the entire evening, the entire night. Our team weather coverage will continue. And we also want to make sure that you stay safe tonight as the tornado watch continues until 5 a.m. So please have a couple methods that you can get. If there happened to be a tornado warning for your area, you're able to get that very critical information and then take cover if needed. So main game in town, this band of rain that is lifting to the north, that will likely be into Savannah. Let's see, we're coming up very close to 9 p.m. Probably between 10 p.m. and midnight, the heaviest rain will be sweeping in, and then we have to watch these stronger storms that have been lurking near and just off our coastline. All right, that is the very latest. We'll have another live update coming up on WJCL 22 at 9 p.m., 10 p.m., and then our full newscast coming up at 11, and then we'll stay on as long as needed to keep you and your family safe tonight. Thank you for trusting us, and we will see you with our team weather coverage coming up at the top of the hour. Take care.